Ahmad, Imam Shafi, Imam Ali ibn Hanbal, Imam Abu Hanifa, Imam Malik, all the great four Ahmad said that if you find any of my fatwa which goes against Allah and His Rasul, throw my fatwa on the wall.
وَإِذَا صَحَّ الْحَدِيثُ فَهُوَ مَذْهَبِي. And if you find the hadith which is authentic, then that is really my mother.
And unfortunately and sadly, in many, many circles, especially amongst the youngsters, there are so many discussions, so many arguments, so many debates, so many confusions. Many people, subhanAllah, they think that as long as you are following a sahih narration, that is okay. But the Prophet didn't say, follow sahih hadith. He said, follow sunnah. And the sunnah, ordinary person can't come up with it. And this is the responsibility of the fuqaha. So when you follow the fuqaha, who have been followed for almost 12 centuries. Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah, like I said, up to today even, more than half the ummah follows Hanafi fiqh. A large portion of the ummah follows Imam Shafi. A large chunk again follows Imam Malik rahimahullah. And perhaps from all the fuqaha, the least is Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal rahimahullah. His followers are mainly in Saudi Arabia, or used to be. Nowadays, there's a general trend to abolish. They think even taqleed or following the a'imma is a bid'ah, is a shirk. That is not the case, my dear brothers. That is not the case. If you're following a mujtahid scholar, and one other thing, ulama have stated the wisdom that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, through these fuqaha, has preserved all acceptable variations in opinion. As there are some variations in opinion which were unacceptable. All the a'imma have rejected them. Whatever has been taken up by Imam Abu Hanifa, or Imam Shafi, or Imam Malik, or Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal, Allah wanted all possibilities, all acceptable variations to remain in the ummah, so they have remained. And anything which hasn't been taken up by the fuqaha, even though it might be in sahih hadith, then it shows, if it wasn't taken up by the a'imma, then it is matruk. It is matruk, it was abolished, or not kept up by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam or the Sahaba. Otherwise, the Sahaba would have kept up, and it would have been taken up by the Ummah. So what has been abolished and didn't exist for 12 centuries, and now if people want to follow it, some people say, people like Imam Abu Hanifa, they say, my madhab is Sahih Hadith. If you bring any Sahih Hadith and it goes against what I have said, throw what I have said on the wall and follow Sahih Hadith. Have you heard this? Most people have heard this. And so what they say, look, this says in Bukhari, Sahih Hadith, so you have to throw out what Abu Hanifa said, but I have yet. And if anybody can bring me one issue, in which they can prove that there is a Sahih, undisputed Hadith which goes against a qawl of Abu Hanifa rahimahullah, and which doesn't have a sahih hadith to back it up, I would love dearly to someone to prove even a single issue, which Imam Abu Hanifa has spoken, and he goes against a sahih hadith, which is unanimously, universally accepted, and for which there is no other contradiction, then I would love them to prove it. But I don't think anyone will be able to prove a single hadith issue, a fatwa of Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah, or Imam Shafi, or Imam Malik, or Ahmad bin Hanbal rahimahullah, for that argument, which goes is against a hadith which is undisputed. Against a hadith which is undisputed. If it appears to go against a hadith which is sahih, then I can guarantee you there is another sahih hadith elsewhere to support what the imams have said. Or, if there is a qawl of any of the imams, and it appears to contradict a sahih hadith, then there is another sahih hadith to contradict that hadith somewhere else. And ordinary people don't know that. But by making such claims, and many scholars, Dr. Zakir Naik, Abdul Rahim Green, Abu Amina Bilal Phillips, and by making such claims, and I have yet to hear, I've seen many clips, Zakir Naik, Bilal Phillips, Abu Usama, Abdul Rahim Green, making all these claims that Imam Abu Hanifa said, if you see a sahih hadith, which goes against what I have said, throw my core on the wall, follow this Sahih Hadith. But no one as yet has presented a single example of such an amal, which either Imam Abu Hanifa has, what he said, goes against a Sahih Hadith, and there is no other Sahih Hadith to contradict it. So when people make such claims on the internet or all over the world, what they are really saying, don't follow Abu Hanifa, don't follow Shafi, don't follow Imam Malik, don't follow Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal, follow Sahih Hadith only. But oh, you don't know whether that Hadith is really Sahih. You don't know whether that Hadith is mansukh or not. And even if it is classified as Sahih, it's not been classified as Sahih by Rasulullah. It's been classified as Sahih by other muhaddisun. So if you're going to follow another man's opinion at the end of the day, then what's wrong with following the opinion of a man whose opinion has already been followed over for 12 centuries? So we can't get away from the fact that all of us are blind followers, and we have no choice but to be blind followers. Because if somebody says this is Sahih Hadith, how are you going to guarantee 100% it is Sahih? It's not, the Prophet didn't say it, another man said it. And Imam Bukhari, rahimahullah, for example, in his compilation, there are 8-9 chains. Imam Bukhari didn't meet them all. He only had to base his judgment on what he heard, hearsay. So you have to place your trust blindly on Imam Abu Hanifa or Albani or other muhaddisun or bin Baz, that what he is saying is Sahih. And is it really Sahih? You can argue all night and all day till Qiyamah, and you will go round and round. We've got no choice but to place blind trust. So if you're going to place our trust somewhere and trust someone, yes, then why not follow the people who have been followed for 12 centuries? And by following them, what's happened? It's produced great muhaddisun, great fuqaha, great ulama, and people have managed and lived together. And mashallah, deen has prospered. But now, in this time and age, we see so much fitna on the name of Quran and Hadith.